Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byf here. So, I promised you guys an analysis of the launch trailer, and here it is. Sorry this didn't get released earlier. YouTube's sub boxes have been weird as of late, so if this gets removed or deleted, that's probably why. I want to make sure that this video gets out to all of you, because this is some of the biggest analysis that we've had of the year. It's really important. So, without much further ado, let's jump into this nonsense. Now, one last thing before we do jump in, though. I don't want to go over any story content. The reason why is not because I want to avoid spoilers. I don't believe in avoiding spoilers if there are any in the trailers. I believe in confronting them full on. But in a video where I actually notify you about them and where I'm talking about exclusively story stuff, that's going to be coming much closer to the launch of Taken King. In the meantime though, let's talk about all of the cool stuff we saw with gear. So, here's the real stuff. Starting off with this Titan over here. This Titan is wearing an exotic helmet that looks like an astronaut's visor. Oh, glorious. So glorious. So, of all the Titan exotics we know of thus far, we only know really of Imperium Bellicose. So if this is another Titan exotic helmet that we're getting with the Taken King, I'd want it to have slightly better perks than simply levitation when you're aiming your gun. Angel of Light really isn't the greatest of perks. And yeah, that's really all I can say on this one. Maybe it'll do something cool to do with public events and warsats, but that's like the biggest stab in the dark that anyone could possibly give. Sadly, we don't even know what this helmet is called. It's just, yeah, there's nothing on it. It's really saddening, actually, because I'd love to see what this thing does, and what it's called, and what little tidbits of lore that Bungie has locked away in it for us. You know, this is just a cool-looking helmet. Something else worth noting is that in this frame, you can also see the Hunter is actually using the Last Word, but I believe he's using the Year 2 variant. And this is because, well, it looks ever so slightly different. You can see that it is the Last Word because of the super characteristic gold plate on the top, as well as the, well, the barrel there. You can see there's a little bit more detail on it. But, in particular, when you take a look at this thing, it's got slightly lighter gold on it. Maybe they've changed it to this white-plated gold, something closer to Electrum or Platinum? I don't know. Could be interesting, and we do know that the Lost Word is coming as a Year 2 exotic, so tell me more about what you think on this particular matter in the comments below. Next up, we see something really exciting. Those right there could be Warlock exotic boots. And oh my gosh, if they are Warlock exotic boots, I'm gonna cry with joy, because we've never had exotic boots. We get to experience what Titans and Hunters got. This is awesome, guys. Finally. Whatever they do, I think that given that they look similar to the Alchemist Raiment chest, and, well, they're also kind of blue and aesthetic, they're going to be something to do with the new Arc Warlock subclass, aka the Stormcaller. So expect maybe something like you get Ionic Blink for free, as crazy OP as that would be, or maybe just something along the lines of, I don't know, increased mobility. Any of those potentially could be what these are, but I don't know. Again, this is all speculation for the part of me. In addition, if you can just about inch into one of the shots, you can see that this Titan on the right-hand side of the screen is actually not only using a really basic-looking set of armor that's like a Titan set of mid-tier greens, and maybe those are going to be more powerful given that it's Taken King and, you know, greens are going to be more powerful than our old legendaries, but also he's using the exotic class item, which is the mini Mjolnir Flame Hammer of Soul nonsense. Oh my god, I love the look of that thing, I want it. That's like the coolest Titan mark I've ever seen. Next up, two interesting things. First of all, if you take a look at this Hunter, you can see that his hood on his cloak is down for some reason. Not sure entirely why that is, but it's also well worth noting that on his back, you can see the chaperone. This is an exotic shotgun. I have more information on the chaperone and an exotic preview of it. That's going to be linked in the description for you guys. Next up in this shot here, we can see the Warlock is wielding an auto rifle of some sort. But get this! There's a bayonet on the end of that thing, much like Red Death. What the hell does that mean? Could this actually just be a Year 2 variant of Red Death? I doubt it because the scope is different. However, could this be another alternate version? Perhaps a Red Death from the past? A Red Death that's maybe just bound up in its old self before it was corrupted in the way it was by all of the Guardians that killed for it? Or perhaps it's just a blue water rifle? I don't know, dude. This could be something really potentially cool, but something even cooler is if you shift over to the Hunter. Now, the Hunter has two really interesting things about them. First of all, you can see the cloak that they're using is similar to the ones that you can find on the Scion Flayers. For those of you who have not played this PlayStation exclusive Strike, basically they are the bosses at the end of the Strike, so maybe this means that you do get Strike-specific loot. If that's the case, I'm looking forward to it, because this is a really goddamn cool-looking cloak. Secondly, of course, there is the weapon that the Hunter is using. Looks pretty similar to Thunderlord, doesn't it? And also it's firing void rounds, what the hell? I'm starting to feel like the Year 2 version of Thunderlord is allowing you to switch whatever ability and element that you're using on it, because last time that we saw a trailer like this in the Game Informer trailer drop for the first part where they were covering their content, we saw one of these with flame elements to it. So who knows, maybe that's what Thunderlord does, although I doubt it, seeing as it really does sort of break the meaning and the name and the point of Thunderlord as this really big arc machine gun. But who knows, maybe there's one that does all three elements. I don't know, we'll see what happens. Finally, however, a third thing on this hunter, which I literally noticed as I was scrolling over, but it is actually also mentioned later in the video, there's a new exotic chess piece. I'm not going to go ahead and speak too much in detail about it now, because again, I'll talk about it in a few minutes. But following that up immediately, if you freeze frame just before this warlock starts to blow Valus Varun away, I think that's his name, you can see that he's wearing a helmet that I've spoken a little bit about before. Again, everything that we know about this is speculation, but it could be something to do with a Voidwalker subclass buff, or it could be something to do with the new Arc Warlock, and that they're just trying to show it off here. I'm not 100% sure. I'll leave my video in the description in case you're interested in my just analysis and speculation on that particular helmet. And next up, the thing that has everyone hyped. Yes. Whilst we may not necessarily be able to wear Oryx's arse like a hat, we can most certainly wear Darkblade's head like a hat. This is the Darkblade helmet. You can tell that this thing is related, certainly, to Darkblade, because, I mean, look at it. This is the head of Darkblade that I just edited in on the right-hand side, and this is the thing that we have in-game, this new thing. It's an exotic, that's gotta be for certain. I have no doubt about it, because it's a unique-looking helmet. However, given that it possibly drops from the Darkblade, and maybe that's a story element to it, I'd love to see where they take this. This could be a really good example of using quests as a way of manufacturing cool and interesting ways to get exotics. Plus, in one of the interviews that Luke Smith did recently with IGN while they were at PAX, there was an amazing point at which he said that in the test build, he acquired more legendaries in the first 10 hours of play than he had done in most of vanilla Destiny. That brings me a huge amount of confidence. Wow. Could be really good. Some people also raised questions about the sniper rifle that he's holding. I don't necessarily know if this is an exotic. I possibly think this could be one. There's a reason for that too. In a Forbes article, which I'm also linking in the description, there was talk of an exotic sniper rifle that could blind opponents that it hit. If so, that's a really potent weapon for starters, but also it's going to be well worth noting that this could potentially do it, because the sound of that gun is rather unique. Exotics not only have unique looks, but they also have unique sounds. Take a look at No Land Beyond and Yallahorn. All of these weapons have their own unique sound cues, and they become exceptionally recognizable. Again, probably the best example for us Crucible nerds is going to be Thorn. People who hear that genuinely run in fear. It's really recognizable. Now, here we can see a hunter who is just starting to wield the Void Bow for the first time, but in particular of interest is this chest piece. Looks very similar to an exotic armor piece on the hunter that we saw before, but probably never used because it was garbage. This is the ATS Arachnid 8. This thing is genuinely the worst exotic in the game. Improves the zoom on your golden gun, which can be good and can be bad, but also you could have a fourth golden gun shot. And in PvE, there is no reason to use this over Celestial Nighthawk. So why this exists, I probably don't know. Having said that, you do have a chest piece that looks very similar to it. The alternative is that this is the Year 2 version of Lucky Raspberry. I've seen that potentially thrown around on the internet for a few points, but I feel like this is just a new exotic altogether. It just looks unique. Not exactly a story point here, but you can see those figures in the background of the Queen's shot here. Now, these guys are actually pretty interesting because these potentially could be one of two groups which, to the lore of Destiny, are very good. Talking about them here doesn't exactly spoil anything of the story, seeing as both groups potentially have really close access to the Queen anyway. The first group is known as the Tekkens, and the Tekkens are basically this kind of massive cult of individuals within the Awoken society that tinker with machines, manage their technology, and are responsible for innovation and the invention of new weapon systems, new just life habs, supports, all this kind of stuff that keeps the Reef going and keeps it as a very strong power in the region. So these guys could be potentially pretty important. The other possibility is that these are members of the Awoken Witch Covens. For those of you who don't know, every single asteroid has an Awoken Witch Coven there. They're kind of the ruling group of that particular asteroid or section of the Reef. This could be a top tier level of Witch Coven membership. And who knows, maybe when you're seeing these guys in-game, you're seeing the leadership of the entirety of the Reef. That could be potentially pretty cool. Or it could just be the Queen's personal council. I'm not entirely sure on this one issue, but it's worth raising with you guys if you're interested in the lore. Next up, we can see this Titan raising his solar hammer. But take a look at those shoulder pieces. They're huge! Like, enormous levels of huge, and they look very Cabal-like. And I would expect that you get these from killing the Shield Brothers. Keep in mind that strike-specific loot and rewards are a thing that have been added to the Taken King, so it's entirely plausible that this will happen. On this next shot of this Warlock here, you can also see that there is a symbol of the War Mines. So, potentially we get more armor, maybe this comes from the Saber 2 Strike. I don't know. There's a lot of interesting possibilities here. I don't think this is an exotic, but maybe I'm wrong. Who knows? Now, here's something interesting. This Hunter is wielding a hand cannon. Now, Martin from Destiny Overwatch earlier speculated that this could have been Cade 6's personal hand cannon, and there's some good reasoning that he gives for it, and quite a few interesting things that he digs up from previous trailers, so I'm going to go ahead and link his video in the description and leave an annotation for it, as I've been doing with all the other stuff in the top right. Next up, you can see that this Warlock here has a very interesting set of robes. I don't think these are exotic, but some people earlier were speculating that these could be due to the fact that there is something that looks similar to a ghost on the front of them. Again, I'm not sure if this is an exotic, and nobody knows if that is true for sure or not, but I thought it was worth raising with you guys. Tell me what you think of that in the comments section down below. In the meantime, sorry that this was all so long, but that's everything I got. Any details that I didn't cover here, specifically I'm probably saving because it's something to do with the story. And again, as I said, a video will be coming out on that much later. And I apologize to you guys if this comes to you a little bit late, I'm trying to wait for YouTube's sub-box situation to resolve itself. So if it still hasn't done so by this point, then I apologize greatly. In the meantime though, go ahead and make sure that you subscribe to my channel and like this video. I have a lot more Taken King stuff coming up, and I assure you guys that it's going to be worth it. I've got loads of great videos that I think everyone here would be interested in. But in the meantime, my name is Bife. Per Ardacia Ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.